Today, I'm going to show you how much strength training you should be doing as a runner if you want to run faster and prevent injuries. Hey runners, my name is Alina Kennedy. I'm a physiotherapist and strength and conditioning specialist with sprintrehab.com. Strength training is something that tends to be underrated by runners and unfortunately not done often enough. And I totally get why. As a runner myself, I would much rather be out running than doing lunges in the gym. But as runners, we need to do more than just run. And strength training forms an important part of a healthy, balanced routine, and it has huge benefits. Not only are stronger muscles overall going to help you run faster, but with strength training, you can also target specific muscles that we know help improve running form and reduce your risk of injuries. First, there are no specific number of strength training hours that work perfectly for every runner. I can't stand here and tell you that you need to do exactly 2 hours every week to be a great runner. It actually depends on a few things like your experience, your current training season, and how many hours you're spending training every week. So instead of giving you a specific number of hours, I'm going to share with you the basic formula that I use to plan training. To use this formula, you're first going to add up your total training time for a week. So if you know that you can work out for an hour 4 times a week, that means your total training time is going to be 4 hours. Now, with those 4 hours, you're then going to strategically divide your time among everything that you need to fit in for that week. So that's not only your slow running, but it's also tempo running, it's interval or speed work running, it's cross training, and of course, strength training. So I like to use a pie chart to visualize how I'm going to divide my time. And within that pie chart, we need to make time for those 5 things: your slow running, tempo running, speed work, cross training, and strength training. So this is the basic formula that I use. 30% is allocated to slow running, 15% to tempo running, 10% to interval or speed work. Cross training is going to be 15% and strength training is 30%. So all of your various running is going to make up over half of your training time with 55%. Then the other 45% of your time is going to be split between cross training and strength training. Now, if we go back to your total weekly training time, you can then calculate how much time you need to be spending doing each thing. So let's take our 4 total weekly training hours, which equates to 240 minutes, and we can calculate 30% of that for slow distance running. 240 times 0.3 equals 72 minutes. We're then going to use that same calculation for strength training, so again, 30% is 72 minutes. Tempo running is 15%, so 240 times 0.15 is 36 minutes, speed work is 24 minutes, and cross training is also 36 minutes. So now that you've got these numbers, you can plan out your week and fit everything into your schedule. Of course, you can adjust the numbers a bit to suit you, your time and your plans, but it does give you a really good base to start from. So with the 72 minutes of strength training, you can round that up to say 75 minutes and do 1 30-minute workout and then 1 45-minute workout, or you can do 3 25-minute workouts that is going to add up to that 75 minutes for the week. And then that goes for all the other training as well. So you can do 30 minutes of cross training instead of the 36 minutes that's allocated. But the idea is that you get a good close approximation of how much training you need to do in each category. So I hope this formula makes sense. So again, it's 30% long distance running, 30% strength training, 15% tempo running, 15% cross training, and 10% interval running. I found this formula to work really well for anyone who is training between 3 to 6 hours a week and preparing for an event like a 10K, half marathon, or full marathon. But there are certain scenarios where I will adjust these numbers slightly. So, firstly, if you are off season, so you're not training for anything in particular, I do slightly increase the strength training and cross training portions to 40% strength training and 20% cross training. I also reduce the long distance running to 25%, but I keep the tempo run at 15%. And you'll notice that I completely eliminate the interval running during off season. I think that this formula also works better for new runners, so anyone who is building up their fitness and endurance or training for their first 5 or 10K race. I would also make adjustments for anyone who is training more than 6 hours a week. So particularly for runners who are very well conditioned at an elite level or are preparing for long distance events that are longer than full marathons. I think for those individuals, 1.5 to 2 hours of strength training is more than enough, even if the percentage drops down to lower than the 30% that's recommended. So that's the basic formula that I use. And I hope that it gives you some insight and helps you plan your training. But as I mentioned at the start, every runner is a bit different. So if you feel that this formula, this schedule doesn't work well for your needs, please get in touch with a running coach who will be able to create something that's more individualized to you. And as always, if you have any questions about this video or anything else, please leave a comment down below and I will be sure to answer you. Thank you for watching. My name is Alina Kennedy and I will see you in the next video.